like the third time I done made this video. My question that I had put on Facebook earlier, I wanted to make a video because I wanted to my voice to be heard. My question has to do with relationships. I have a lot of people on my Facebook page that are married, a lot of people that are in relationships, a lot of single people. But my question is, it's like a question and a statement. My question is, when do you know that you love someone? That's the question. And my statement is, I've been in love with somebody for about 18 months now. And, you know, a relationship has its ups and downs. And she's going to say that I'm telling all of our business on Facebook, which I'm not. I'm posing a question. Because I'm confused right now. I'm in a confused state. You know, love is a hard thing to go about. It's hard to be in love. Sometimes it's hard for people to show love. But what do you do when you're in love with a person and you feel like there's so many secrets to that person? And this is just a question I'm posing. I'm not really saying, trying to indict my relationship or put my person out there on blast, because I'm not. But when do you know that the person that's next to you is giving you 100? When do you know that the person that you say that you love is giving you that? See, I can admit, and I will admit to all of my friends on Facebook, you know, I'm in my mid-30s, and I've only had love from, like, 3 people. Outside from my family, I've only had love from 3. And one of the people that I've had love from is the person that I'm currently entangled with. And I say entangled, and I use that word loosely. But that's one of the people that I've had love from. Now, you know, on Facebook, they have this thing where it says you're in a complicated relationship. I don't think my relationship is complicated, but I think that, you know, everybody has to work on it. You know what I'm saying? Like, a relationship isn't going to just go together. It's going to be something that you have to be willing to work on, and the person that you're dealing with is going to have to be willing to work on as well. It's a lot to be in a relationship. And a lot of stuff comes along and it tests your relationship. You know, you might have outside people trying to get at you, exes trying to get at you, you know, temptations and all that stuff. But it's a lot to be in a relationship. And I think the one thing that gets lost is what the person is willing to do to be in a relationship with you or keep that relationship going. It doesn't matter how many times that you argue. It doesn't matter how many times that you seem like you're about to break up. It's about what that person is willing to do to keep the relationship going. You know, it might be tolerating people that they don't need to necessarily tolerate. It might be taking on more responsibility or something that they've never had to deal with. But it's your willingness to show love or to give love no matter what. See, a lot of people don't understand the word unconditional love. And unconditional love should be first and foremost in your relationship. Especially if you're to the point where you're saying, I love you and we're going to be together and it's just me and you. It has to be unconditional. You can't love a man or a woman because of what they have. And you can't love them less because of what they don't have. And a lot of people get caught up in that. You know, in the beginning, if your woman has a job and or she's cleaning or she does special things for you and then she stops, but you say you love her, you still have to love her. Same for a man. If a man was in a relationship with you and he was buying you things or he was taking care of this and that, and all of a sudden it stops for whatever reason, but you say you love him, you must love him. Or that love was not unconditional. See, a lot of people get lost in this whole situation and they don't know what unconditional love is or what love is for that fact. And they just go saying, I love you, and spurting it out to everyone that they're with. That's not unconditional. You have to love a person for what they are, not for what they do. And a lot of that gets lost nowadays, because you want to look at the man's car or the man's earning status or the way he dresses or, he used to take you to the nice restaurants and all that there. But see, God has a funny way of making things happen. God takes away the things that are unnecessary from a person. Like if you met this man and he was balling out of control and had all this money, God is going to take away his money. Not because he wants to punish that man, but he wants to see if you're going to stay with that man if he doesn't have these things. God has ways of testing you that you never know of. It never just comes to you in plain sight. And I know half of y'all think I'm crazy. I'm making this video in my car. It's a Sunday afternoon. I just got through watching the Cowboys lose. Yeah, I had to put that out there for the Cowboy fans. I'm sorry. I rep for the New Orleans Saints, see the black and gold. Anyway, but my point is, I had to put this video out because of the woman that I love, and to let her know that I have unconditional love for her no matter what. She might look at this video and say, hey, he's going on Facebook, putting my business out there again. No, we're okay. Our relationship is intact. Hopefully she understands what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to let the world know, the millions of people in the world, about the woman that I love. Antonia Nicole Williams. That is the woman that I love. So if I'm willing to sit here and put a video out on Facebook and admit my love to my woman, my love must be unconditional. But I don't want anything in return from her. I just want her to know how I feel. And hopefully she does. Hopefully she gets this. She understands. And she knows that my love is real. There's a lot of men ain't willing to do what I'm willing to do. Or a lot of men wouldn't do what I'm willing to do. Yeah, this might be embarrassing to the average man. See, the average man doesn't have the heart that I have. I got a lot of friends on here that are married, have long-lasting relationships, and whatever works in their relationship works in their relationship. What I'm trying to do now, is I'm at a point, my mid-30s, I'm not going to disclose my real age on here. I'm old. You can see the gray hair, okay? You know I'm old. But at this point, I don't want to keep messing around with different women. That's not going to solve anything. So it's like this is a public service announcement or something. When you have a good woman or a good man by your side, you keep them. You know what I'm saying? You do whatever is necessary to keep that relationship going. But you got to also look at it that a lot of people tolerate stuff that they shouldn't necessarily have to tolerate. You know what I'm saying? The one thing I can't stand, and I hear about this all the time on Facebook, and just dealing with friends and stuff, is exes. You shouldn't necessarily have to deal with a person's ex unless, you have a child with this person. That's the one pet peeve I have, but sometimes you got to be willing to go through the fire for the person that you with. But it has to be a general understanding between both of y'all that, hey, I'm dealing with this, but I'm dealing with this because I love you. And some of it don't need to be dealt with at all, but some people just don't get it through their head that, some things are unnecessary. Another reason why I put this video out is because I had a conversation with my ex-wife. A lot of y'all know who she is. And the one thing she told me that I have to mention is that she wanted her next relationship, which she's engaged right now. I'm happy for her. But the one thing she said she wanted from her next relationship is to be the apple of her, you know, her companion's eye. Which what that means is that she wanted her man to represent her at all times. She wanted to be known to the world that so what I'm doing now is I'm letting the world know of the woman that I consider to be the apple of my eye. That's why I put this video out. Not to step on her feet. Not to bash her, because we all have our flaws. I have mine. This might be a flaw right here. Me putting this video out. But she's the apple of my eye. But she has to realize that she's the apple of my eye. And she has to realize that I'm willing to go through the fire with her. But does she realize that? Only she can answer that question. If I wasted some of y'all time with this long, drawn-out video, I apologize. I just had to get my feelings out. So, y'all enjoy y'all Sunday. Cowboy fans, keep y'all head up. Saints fans, we number one in the division. Cleveland Cavaliers fans, we won a game. Lakers fans, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. But anyway, just wanted to tell y'all, you know, if you got love, if you got someone that you love and someone that loves you, hold on to it. No matter how bad it seems like it is, or, you know, no matter what you hear, the whispers from the people behind you about, you know, the man's character or the female's character, if that person is doing you right or making every attempt to do you right, man, just hold on to it. And if you don't have love yet, it's going to come to you. I read a lot of people saying that, you know, why am I single? And, you know, why is this? And I've made the same, you know, questions. I had the same questions, like, why is this? But sometimes you just got to, you know, love will be right in front of your face and you don't even see it. And then if you got it, you got to be willing to hold on to it. So I'm saying that. Peace out to my friends. See y'all later, man. I will be making more videos. I find this to be kind of fun and therapeutic. I know. This is what happens when you don't have a life. So anyway, I'll holler at y'all.